Hi, hello to everyone. In this video, let us discuss carbon family. So what are that 4th A group elements and their general properties? So let us see here. So what are that 4th A group elements are called carbon family? Elements are carbon, silicon, germanium, tin, lead and fluorium. So these are the 4th A group elements. What are atomic numbers here? Carbon atomic number 6, silicon 14, 32, 50, 82, 114. These are the atomic numbers of which one 4th A group elements. And general electronic configuration is NS2, NP2. General electronic configuration NS2, NP2. Now here, let us see the abundance and occurrence of these elements. So which is most abundant element and their occurrence in the nature. So now first let us see the carbon here. Carbon is the most versatile element in the nature. Of course, that available in free state in the form of diamond, graphite and coal. So in that free state, carbon is available in the nature and human body, that means carbon is present more amount in which one, means human body also contain more amount of which one carbon. So like that, the nature is containing most of the elements in which one, means carbon only. Okay, then but in the earth crust, it is the 17th most abundant element. So in earth crust, carbon available as carbonates. So like that, that available in the nature, that available in compound state as CO2. And carbon is having three isotopes, C12, C13, C14. These are the three isotopes available for which one, carbon. And C14 is a radioactive element and its half-life period is 5770 years. And it is used in radiocarbon dating. For what purpose? Means to estimate the age of some old things. So in radiocarbon dating, we use which one, means C14. So this is regarding which one, availability of carbon. And this is 17th most abundant element in the earth crust. And if you come to the silicon, it is the second most abundant element in the earth crust. What is the mass percentage? Means 27.7% by mass that available in the earth crust. And silicon available in form of which one, silica and silicates. That means marbles, that silicates, they contain which one, means nothing but silicon. So this is the second most abundant element in the earth crust. Okay, this is regarding which one, that availability. Of course, the remaining elements are less available in the earth crust. In 4th A group elements, that which one, remaining elements, germanium, tin, lead, those are less abundant in the earth crust. Okay, now let us go for some properties of these elements here. Before going to that, one important thing, carbon contain 2 electrons in which one, penultimate shell. Penultimate shell contains 2 electrons, which one, means carbon. Of course, silicon contain 8 electrons in penultimate shell, but other 4th A group elements contain 8 electrons in penultimate shell. So for this reason, carbon shows some anomalous properties. In every group, the first element shows which one, anomalous properties. In the similar way, in 4th A group elements, carbon shows some anomalous properties. Let us see what are the anomalous properties of carbon here. So first anomalous property here, carbon is most abundant element in nature in free state. So carbon available in free state, but remaining fourth a group elements not available in free state. So that is one anomalous property of which one? That carbon. And second anomalous property is here, carbon does not form which one? Carbon can form multiple bonds with itself and also with some other elements having high electronegativity. But other fourth A group elements do not form multiple bonds like carbon among themselves and also with some other elements. This is another anomalous property of which one? Carbon. And another one here, carbon maximum covalency is 4. Maximum covalency of carbon is 4. But other fourth A group elements, they exhibit maximum covalency is how much means 6. If you consider silicon, that form SiF6-2. By expanding its octet electron, octet, that means by expanding octet configuration, it forms SiF6-2. So due to the presence of vacant d orbitals, in other elements, maximum covalency increases to 6. But in carbon, that maximum covalency is how much means only 4. So these are which one now? Some anomalous properties of which one? That carbon. Another property is also there. What is that means? Carbon shows catenation ability. Means that carbon atoms join together with one another to an infinity distance. But in other elements of that fourth A group, this catenation ability is limited. That means in case of silicon, catenation extends up to 8 atoms only, not having that of infinity order. So like that here, carbon can form longest chains, either cyclic or this chain form, whatever it may be, that can extend this chain to an infinity distance. So this is also another anomalous property of which one? That carbon. Okay, these are anomalous properties of carbon. Now let us see what are that some general properties of these fourth A group elements. What are the general properties means? First one is atomic size. As usual, increases from top to bottom, but carbon to silicon, there is a large increase in atomic size. As in case of which one? Third A group elements. From boron to aluminium, there is a sudden increase in atomic size. In the similar way, from carbon to silicon, there is a sudden increase in atomic size, but thereafter, somewhat less increase in atomic size. Okay, this is regarding which one? Atomic size. Now let us see ionization potential values. So now ionization potential values decreases from top to bottom. From carbon to that, of course, lead, or you can consider FL. Also what happens here, IP values decreases. But there is a sudden decrease in ionization potential from carbon to silicon. Due to which one? Sudden increase in atomic size. There is a sudden decrease in ionization potential from carbon to silicon. Thereafter, that less pronounced, the decrease in IP value is less pronounced, not sudden decrease. Okay, this is regarding ionization potential. Okay, then come to densities. So except carbon, densities increases from silicon to bottom of the group. Silicon to bottom. Why we are saying except carbon means, carbon is having highest density in form of diamond. So except carbon, density increases from which one? Silicon to that lead also you can consider. And no need to consider the last element. okay, up to lead we can confine our discussion. Okay, then after that melting point and boiling point values. So now these values decreases from top to bottom. Decreases from top to bottom because from top to bottom M dash M bond length increases and bond energy decreases. So that's why here melting and boiling point values decreases. And carbon has highest melting point and boiling point value in form of which one? Diamond. So this is regarding which one? Melting and boiling point values of these elements. Then come to the electronegativity. So now here from top to bottom electronegativity decreases. Carbon electronegativity 2.5, silicon, germanium and tin, these electronegativity value equals to 1.8 and lead electronegativity value 1.9. that means except for carbon, in remaining elements electronegativity almost remains same. So this is regarding which one? Here electronegativity of these elements. Now let us see which one nature of elements, that means metallic or non-metallic nature we have to see here. In this, carbon, silicon are purely which one means non-metals, and germanium and tin both are having which one means semi-metal character, means metalloids. But here tin is having somewhat more metallic nature. Of course metalloid only, but somewhat more metallic character is there. And if you consider lead, it is having which one means metallic character. So this is regarding which one? Nature of these elements. Okay, after this let us go for which one? Oxidation state. So what is the general configuration? NS2, NP2. So due to this general configuration, plus 2 and plus 4 are common oxidation states of 4th A group elements. But plus 2 stability increases from top to bottom due to inert pair effect. Due to which effect means inert pair effect. Plus 4 stability decreases and plus 2 stability increases. That means for lead, plus 2 oxidation state is more stable than that of plus 4. So this is regarding which one? Oxidation states of 4th A group elements. So these are the general properties of which one? Of that 4th A group elements. And after that let us see chemical reactivity. What happens chemical reactivity? Let us see here. Chemical reactivity increases from top to bottom. First let us see reactivity with water. So now here carbon, silicon, germanium do not react with water, and tin react with water, and that forms which one? SnO2 and liberate hydrogen gas. And if you come to lead, not affected by water due to the formation of oxide film. Due to the formation of oxide film, lead not affected by the water. So this is regarding which one? Reactivity with water. Okay, then second one here, which one? Halogens. Reactions with halogens and halides. So now let us see what are the type of halides formed by the 4th A group elements. These elements give two type of halides, MX2 and MX4, dihalides, and another one, which one here? Tetrahalides. Okay, now if you consider that lead, in case of lead, if you consider PbX2 more stable than PbX4, this is which one stability order. But in case of germanium, GeX4 is more stable than GeX2. Again, what is the reason for PbX2 stability means? We know that what is that inert pair effect. So due to the inert pair effect, PbX2 more stable than which one? PbX4. One question we get here, what is that? PbI4 doesn't exist. What is the reason? They give the question. What is the reason means? The energy liberated when PB-I bond is formed. The energy liberated when PB-I bond is formed, not enough to unpair the NS2 electron pair present in which one? Lead. So the heat energy liberated while the formation of PB-I bond is not enough to unpair the NS2 electrons present in lead. So it is unable to form four bonds. That's why only PbI4 doesn't exist. This is somewhat important question. What is the reason for not existence of PbI4 means? The PbI bond formation energy not sufficient to unpair NS2 electrons present in lead. That we have to give the answer. Okay, this is regarding that PbI2, PbI4 stability regarding that. Okay, then another important one here. What is that means? Now, if you consider carbon halides, that means CX4, they do not undergo hydrolysis. Carbon tetrahalides or halides of carbon do not undergo hydrolysis because here water molecules try to donate lone pair of electrons. They try to donate which one here? Lone pair of electrons. But here the central atom carbon is not having vacant d orbitals to gain that lone pair of electrons. For that reason, carbon tetrahalides do not undergo hydrolysis. But if you consider remaining tetrahalides of these fourth A group elements except carbon, if you consider silicon tetrachloride, this undergoes hydrolysis and produces SiOH taken 4. On heating, this loses water and produces H2SiO3, orthosilicic acid. So like that, except carbon tetrahalides, remaining fourth A group halides will undergo hydrolysis by accepting lone pair of electrons. Now, when they are accepting lone pair of electrons, we can say that they are acting as Lewis acids. So like that, except carbon tetrahalides, remaining fourth A group tetrahalides, by accepting lone pair of electrons, they act as which one? Lewis acids. Okay, another question here. What is that given in so many examinations also? What is that means here? SiF6-2 exists, but SiCl6-2 doesn't exist. What is the reason? They give the question. So what is the reason here means? Here if you consider silicon, it cannot accommodate place for the 6 large chloride ions. So for that reason, here silicon that does not form which one? SiCl6-2. And also another reason we can give, Si-Cl bond is very weak, so it can't exist. Two reasons one can give here. Silicon does not accommodate place for 6 large sized chloride ions. And also another reason, SI dash CL bond becomes which one weaker, so that bond will be broken, so it can't exist. Two reasons we can give. So this is regarding which one? Halides of that fourth A group element, some important topics we have to remember in that. Then come to which one here? Oxides. So now fourth A group elements form monoxide and also dioxide, and in this SiO exist only at elevated temperatures, means at high temperatures only SiO exist. At normal conditions it does not exist. We have to remember that thing. And now let us see the nature of these oxides here. CO2 is and CO2, of course, SiO2. These two are having which nature? Means acidic nature. GeO2 is having amphoteric nature. Okay, SnO2 and GeO2 having amphoteric nature. PbO2 is having metallic nature. And if you come to monoxides, CO is a neutral oxide. And of course, SiO does not exist. We have removed that. And SnO, GeO are having amphoteric nature. And PbO is having which one here? That this is having basic nature. Metallic means nothing but basic. Here PbO also having which one? Basic nature. So this is regarding which one here? Oxides of that fourth A group elements. So these are the chemical properties of which one? That fourth A group elements. Okay, catenation also there in fourth A group elements. Carbon shows high catenation ability. Catenation means self linkage of identical atoms to give chain or ring like structures. And due to the high bond energy of CC bond, carbon is having more ability to form that chain type of structures. So like that, carbon catenation ability is extend up to infinity. And from top to bottom, catenation ability decreases. In silicon, that is confined up to 8 atoms only. Thereafter, further decreases. So this is regarding which one? Physical and chemical properties of fourth A group elements. Okay, in our next class, let us go for which one? Allotropy, allotropes of carbon. Okay.